Hi everyone! Today I will talk about an interesting topic, the Blackmagic Camera app. This is a powerful tool that lets you control various aspects of your iPhone's camera. I'm going to do an overview of the different tools and menu of the application, and then I'm going to go outside and show you in real time how to use the application to create a video. Firstly, if you haven't already done so, you must install the Blackmagic Camera application. To do so, go to the App Store, do a search, and type Blackmagic Camera. You have it here, and choose this one. One here. For me, it's already installed, so I just have to open it. It's open. One thing is important. Before you start creating video, don't forget to clean the lens on your iPhone, because if they are dirty, you will have bad result. Now that we have the app ready, we can start adjusting the setting and preference to suit our filming needs. One more thing, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment my video. This will help me a lot. First, we will access the setting tab on the right side at the bottom. I will start with the setting. I will do a reset of the application, so we have to scroll down. Click on reset. Reset black cam setting and reset the camera setting. I do the reset. Okay, now the application is have all the default setting. The first one we're gonna do is the record. By default, the codec will be in HEVC H.265. You can record in H.265, but you're going to have a little bit less quality. And sometimes it's going to be harder for your computer to do the color grading. Me, by default, I prefer to have the Apple ProRes 422 HQ. It's going to be a huge file, but you're going to have a better quality. And it's going to be easier for your computer for the color grading. Next, we go on camera. The next setting we're going to change is going to be put at 60 hertz. I will like the current orientation, because if you take the phone horizontal position and you have shoot a video and you move it on the right position, by default the application is going to go to a vertical position and it won't be good for the video. So if you like it like this, it's going to stay like this. For the other setting, the first one is the audio source. Now I have only the iPhone microphone, but if you have multiple microphones, this is where you're going to do the change. The next setting I will change is going to be the sample rate, because by default it's in auto. I will put it 48 kilohertz, because you're going to have better quality for the video. In the monitor tab, the only thing I will change is the display battery indicator, because it's always good to know how much battery you have left on your iPhone. In the media tab, you have the option to save clip too. For the moment, it's in the in-app only, but if you have an SSD, this is where you will have to change it. You're going to have to go to file and click on my iPhone and browse for the SSD. Now it's not connected, but this is going to be the place you will have to go. The next one is going to be the LUT. Prefer to enable LUT, because if you don't enable LUT, what you will see on the screen is going to be very flat, and sometimes it's harder to see if it's overexposed or see if there is something wrong with the video. So I enable display LUT. For the LUT selection, I click on this. I already have the Apple ProRes Rec.2709 version 1 LUT installed, so this is the one I will select. If not, you're going to have to import it from a place that you have on your computer and save it to the LUT folder in the Blackmagic Camera app folder. Now we will go in the camera setting. This is where we're going to set up all the settings for our video. The first one is going to be the lens. You have different lens. I have on my iPhone, I have the 13mm, because I have the iPhone 15 Pro Max, the 24mm, and the 120mm. I always choose the native lens on the iPhone. Okay, I will go back to the 24mm, because this is the one going to have better quality. Next, we have the frame per second. To have a more cinematic setting, we will go to the 2398. You have the option to go on up to 60 frames per second if you want to do slow-mo, thing like this. After that, we have the shutter. The shutter by default should be at 2 times the frame per second. To be able to have always double the frame per second for the shutter speed, I will lock the shutter. So you're gonna see a small lock on the right side of the shutter. This means that the shutter is locked. So if I change the frame per second like to something like 23.98, by default it's going to be at 148. It will change it automatically for you. I prefer to have it like this than the shutter angle, because if I have too much light or I want to change the setting for the shutter, it's going to be easier for me. For the iris, we cannot change it, set up by default, because this lens is a fixed lens and we cannot change the aperture of the lens. In the middle, we have the time code, the time that you are recording. So if I start a recording, you're gonna see that it changed. You will see how much time the video is recording. Now we are at the ISO. This is the only place we have to adjust the light in your iPhone when you're recording, if you lock the shutter, unless you have a VND filter in front of the camera. So to adjust the ISO, just tap on it and you can slow it down. You can look at the histogram on the left side. Try to have it in the middle of the small screen. If you want to go faster, you can click on the 400, 800, or 1600. Now, for the white balance, you have different options. Now it's in auto. But if you remember before, we enabled the option to lock white balance when we start recording. So as soon as we click on the record, the white balance, you have a lock on the side, so you won't be able to change it. If I stop recording, the lock disappears. Now you can adjust the white balance. The next setting, we have the tint. This is just to adjust the color of the, like the red or the green on the video. By default, I leave it at auto because it's going to adjust by itself with my setup when I start recording. Now, if you want to see more screen without all the information like the shutter, the time code and everything, the ISO, you just have to swipe up on your screen and everything will disappear. If you swipe down, everything will come back. Next, on the right side of the resolution, we have how much battery left we have. If we go down on the left side, we have the histogram. If the lighting of your video is okay, if you have too much light or not enough light. The next one in the middle, you have the capacity of storage you have for your recording. Next, you have the level of your audio recording. If you tap on it, you're going to see a big screen in the middle of the window. If you have an external microphone, you're going to be able to adjust the gain. But with the default iPhone, you won't be able to adjust it. If you want to remove the screen, just tap on lower right on the microphone setting. The next one, I will start with the Zebra, the first one on the top. By default, the Zebra 85%. I set it at 83%. Because I check with the DaVinci Resolve, and this is the setting that I think is going to be the best for me. I put it on. Next position seems to be okay. You check at the histogram, it's close to be in the middle. But if I change the ISO and I put it at 8, see that we have clipping on the small bottle. If we go higher, we're going to have more clipping. And the histogram will be more on the right too. So always check your histogram. It's a good reference. The next setting is going to be for the focus. If you enable this, you're going to see the red color. That it means that it's in focus. If you tap on the back, see the focus, it will move. If you tap and hold the focus, you're going to see a circle that writes AAAF lock. This means the focus and the exposure are locked. If you move the camera, nothing changes. If you want to focus in automatic, so this means it will focus only on the closest subject in your frame. Next, we have the grid line. They are useful tools for creating better video according to the rule of third. This one is a reference when recording video in different aspect ratio. Next, we have fast color. It's a feature that can read exposure level by displaying video in a different color scheme to make certain detail more noticeable. The next one is the LUT. For the moment, it's at on. If I remove the LUT, you're going to see it's going to be flat. The next one, the stabilization. By default, it's set to standard. You have the option to off no stabilization, also cinematic or extreme. Okay, the next one is going to be the dynamic zoom. I never use it because you're going to lose a lot of quality in your video. This one is for recording some metadata for the next video. That's it for the moment. Now we will go outside and I will show you how to use the camera outside with different subjects. Thank you.
Hello.
while outside, I will do the small video that I talked to you about. I will show you all the setting I have to shoot outside when it's very sunny, because we have a very bright sun today, and with the sun, it's going to be very hard for the exposure. I do not install the VND filter on it because I want to show it to you how to shoot video if you don't have VND filter. I will show you my setting inside the camera. We record on Apple ProRes 422 HQ in 4K, HDR Apple Log, the audio, the iPhone microphone. For the LUT, we have an Apple Log to Rec 709 LUT. So we're going to go back to the camera. Okay, at first, to adjust the exposure with the histogram, I have to remove the automatic feature. I have the lens at 13 millimeter, frame per second is at 60 frames per second, and the shutter I have to crank it 1000. The ISO is at the minimum, and the white balance, I leave it at auto. Check the histogram, it's right in the middle. Now I will shoot everything handheld, and the focus is on my manual, and as I am still at 60 frames per second with the 13 millimeter, I will start from left to right. I'm going to start the recording. Okay, the recording is running. We'll start from left. I will go slowly from left to right, and I will rise a little bit to have the top of the basilic. Now I will lock the focus on the cathedral. Okay, the focus is locked. And I will do a reveal from behind the flower. Start the recording, and I will move slowly from the left. Okay, now I will do a shot from the bottom and I will rise up slowly. Okay, now I will change my lens. I will do some detailed shot. Okay, my first shot. To adjust the exposure, I just tap on the screen what I want the focus and the exposure to be set. So we'll lock it on the window there. Okay, and I will start from the bottom to the top. Start the recording. Okay, for this shot, I will use a tripod because it will be more stable with the 120 millimeter.